हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सब्जेक्ट स्ट्रक्चरल डिज़ाइन एंड ड्राइंग पार्ट 3। आई एम प्रोफेसर प्रिया कुलकर्णी फ्रॉम पार्वतीबाई गेंदबा मोजे कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग वाघोली पुणे। ओके, हियर वील डिस्कस अबाउट द लिमिट स्टेट ऑफ कोलैप्स दैट इज शियर एंड इन दिस सेशन वील लर्न वन न्यूमेरिकल फॉर द लिमिट स्टेट ऑफ कोलैप्स दैट इज शियर। In the previous lecture, we have seen the IS code clause for limit state of shear in page number 45 and 46 and clause number 22.4.1. Okay, there we have seen the criteria or what is the condition to calculate the ultimate shear resistance of section, and there we have seen two parts, that is sections uncracked in flexure and another one is sections cracked in flexure. So if you have any doubts regarding how to calculate the shear resistant capacity of section, just watch the previous video and then continue with this video. Here we'll start with one numerical. Okay, I'll start with the numerical. The cross section of prestressed concrete beam is an unsymmetrical T section with the following dimensions. The dimensions of T section are given as overall depth is equals to 1200 mm, web is equals to 200 mm, flange 1000 by 200 mm. Okay. At a particular section, the beam is subjected to ultimate movement and shear force of 2000 kN and 250 kN respectively. Design the beam for shear with the following data: grade of concrete M40, effective depth 1100 mm, AP is equals to 2310 mm², FP is equals to 1500 MPa, N or it is the efficiency ratio is equals to 0.6, effective pre-stress at extreme tensile face of the beam is given as 19.30 MPa. Okay, so this is this all is given data. Okay, now we see one by one what is given data and what we are supposed to calculate. We are supposed to design the beam for the shear. Okay, but before starting, first of all we have to decide that whether for this given section the shear is required or not. Okay, we have to check that and then we'll start. As they have stated, we have to design. So I think according to the IS code and according to this numerical, we'll check whether it is necessary to design the design the given section for shear or not. Okay, so it is the first criteria for the limit state of shear. We have to first decide whether it is required, that particular shear reinforcement, or not. Okay, then we'll start with the given data. We have given ultimate movement and shear force. Okay, here ultimate moment is given as 2000 kN and shear force is given as 250 kN. Okay, so it is denoted by MU and VU. Okay, then overall depth of the section is given, then effective depth of the section is also given. Effective depth of the section is also given. Okay, so we write the given data and accordingly we'll draw the sketch. Okay, simple unsymmetric I section they have given, simple unsymmetrical T section they have given. Okay, then some data is given. AP is the area of pretensioning tendons is given as 2310 MPa. Then FP, what is FP? FP is the characteristic strength of pre-stressing steel is 1500 MPa. Then FPT is also given. FPT is denoted as, or meaning of FPT is the effective pre-stress after all losses have occurred, with which shall not put together greater than 0.6 fp. These all things are given in the IS code. You just check with the IS code, okay, what is the meaning of a particular symbol or what is the notation they have used, all is there in the IS code, okay. And n is efficiency ratio is given as 0.6, okay. So this much is the given data. Then we'll start with the numerical. So first of all, we are supposed to find the location of neutral axis, okay, where is the neutral axis lies, and then according to the location of the neutral axis, once we get, then we'll find the moment of inertia of the given T section, okay, and then we'll start with the check for shear. Then we'll start with the check for shear. So first of all, this location of neutral axis YB is calculated, and YT, YB is a depth of neutral axis from bottom, YT is the depth of neutral axis from top. It is calculated, it is simple. That we have to do, what we have to do is we have to multiply with the area into d by 2, okay, divided by summation of area, okay, for flange and web section, okay. So accordingly we'll get the YB, and we'll subtract from the overall depth 1200 minus 800, we'll get the YT, okay. Then moment of inertia is BD cube upon 12 for rectangular section, okay, into area into, it is the total depth, it is the depth of that particular rectangular section minus the location of neutral axis that we have calculated here, YB, okay, YB or YT, it is up to you from where you are going to calculate the location of neutral axis, from top or from bottom, both has the same meaning, okay. The value of moment of inertia will come similar or same from if we consider from top and if we consider from bottom, okay. Then the moment of inertia we get is 5.337 into 10 raised to 10 mm raised to 4, okay. This is the moment of inertia calculation. Then starting with the step number 2, it is check for shear, okay. Now here we have considered that the sections are cracked in flexure, okay, this is the assumption that we have made, okay. Why we have made this assumption? Because if we consider sections cracked in flexure, then in flange members where central axis occurs in the flange, the principal stress should be limited to 0.24 fck. That criteria is given, and accordingly this criteria satisfies with all the members, okay. But we have to design for the extreme case or worst case, okay. That's why we have considered that the sections are cracked in flexure, okay. What do you mean by sections cracked in flexure? I have shown one picture in the previous session. Actually shear failure happens in two ways, that is web failure means it is the diagonal failure at the extreme edges or at the ends of particular rectangular beam, if we consider. And what is the meaning of section cracked in flexure? Sections cracked in flexure, it means that the particular failure will occur from the center of the beam, okay, from center of the member. So there is also maximum bending moment at the center, okay. That's why the shear flexural shear is the word they have used, okay. Flexure means bending because of the maximum bending moment, okay, flexure and shear, okay. So flexural shear, it is the worst case. That's why we have to design every part of the structure for the worst case. Okay, that's why we have considered here the sections are cracked in flexure, okay, we are going to calculate for the extreme case or for worst case, that's why. Okay, then there is one formula. This formula is completely there in the IS code, in the clause number 22.4.2, clause number 22.4.2, page number 46 of IS 1343-2012. I have uploaded this IS code in the our Google Classroom. Okay, download from there and just have a look at the page number 46. Okay, the ultimate resistance of a section cracked in flexure VO or VCR is given by VCR is equals to 1 minus 0.55 FPE divided by FP in bracket. Okay, then tau C into BD plus M0 V by M. Okay, just kindly remember this formula. Okay, and it is there in the IS code. Again, I am telling you that we can use IS code in the exams. Okay, so just you have to remember the page numbers, or just you have to remember the clause numbers. Okay, clause number 22.4.2, page number 46. Then before starting with the substitution, I will tell you about what is the notations they have used. FPE is the effective pre-stress after all losses have occurred, which shall not put together greater than 0.6 FP. Okay, FP is characteristic strength of pre-stressing steel. Okay, then tau C. Tau C is the ultimate shear capacity of concrete obtained from table 2.3.1 of IS 1343. Okay, this value of tau C will get from the IS code. Okay, then B is the width of the or breadth of the member for which flange section shall be taken as the breadth of web BW. Okay, now here we are required, we have flange section. Flange sections means P section or I sections that are flange sections. Okay, and if a flange section is given, then we have to consider breadth of web. Okay, BW, just remember this thing. If they have given one rectangular section, then we will consider directly the width of that particular rectangular section. But in case of flange sections, we have to consider the width of web below. Okay, then D is equals to distance from the extreme compression fiber to the centroid of the tendons at the section considered. Okay, then M0 is the movement necessary to produce the zero stress in the concrete at the depth given by. M0 is equals to 0.8 FPTI divided by Y. Okay, just remember each and everything that I am going to explain about the particular notations. Okay, where FPT is the stress due to pre-stress only at a depth D and distance Y from centroid of the concrete section, which has second moment of area I. V and M are shear force and bending moment respectively at the section considered due to ultimate loads, and we have given the shear force and bending moment directly. And VCR shall not be taken less than 0.1 BD FCK, BD under root FCK. Okay, this everything is there in that particular IS code. Okay, so get familiar with the IS code. Then we will put one by one values. Okay, FPE is equals to 'effective pre-stress after all losses have occurred, which shall not put together greater than 0.6 FP. Okay, that's why FPE is equals to 0.6 into FP. 0.6 we have given that as a efficiency ratio, 0.6 into FP. FP we have given as 1500. Okay, so FPE comes as 900 MPa. Then M0 this pointed FPT I by Y is also given in the S code. So just put the particular values of FPT I and Y, we'll get the M0 value in kilonewton meter. Then PT is the percentage reinforcement. Okay, we know how to calculate this percentage reinforcement. It is calculated in percentage AST divided by B into D. Okay, AST divided by B into D. Now here in case of flange section, we have to consider width of wave. So BW into D. Okay, just remember this thing very carefully. In case of flange sections, we have to consider the width of wave. That's why we have considered 200 width of this wave. Okay, then for PT of 1.05 and M 40 grade of concrete, now I'll show the IS code clause or table from the IS code for calculation of tau C. Okay, just a minute, this is the IS code. Okay, in page number 33, sorry, I have made a mistake that I have told you, it is there in the page number 46. Okay, it is there in the page number 32 and 33. Okay, then just consider this table number 8. Okay, and we have PT value that 1.05. Okay, we have PT value of 1.05 and we have given grade of concrete as M40. Okay, now here we have a value that is in between of 1 and 1.25. Okay, so in this case we have to do, the interpolation between the values 1 and 1.25, and we have to consider 1 and 1.25 and 0.68 and 0.74. So in between these two values we have the value corresponding to PT is equals to 1.05. it is there in the IS code table number 8, page number 33. Here then from interpolation we get the value of tau C is equals to 0.69 MPa. Okay, then we know all the values, then we will put the all the given values or what 2-3 values we have found here, we'll put all together in this equation for calculation of ultimate shear resistance of section cracked in flexure, VCR. Okay, then we get the value of VCR is equals to 227.5 kilonewton. Okay, 227.5 kilonewton, and what IS code says that this value VCR, the value of VCR should not be less than 0.1 BD under root FCK. Okay, VCR should not be less than 0.1 under root BD, 0.1 BD under root FCK. So we'll check whether we have the calculated VCR value within the range or not. Okay, it is within the range and therefore it is safe. Okay, that's why we don't have to design for shear. Okay, shear reinforcement, we'll provide nominal shear here. So provide a nominal shear reinforcement of 8 mm by two legged stirrups at 450 mm center to center. This is the basic shear reinforcement. Okay, we haven't designed the shear reinforcement. Okay, if we are supposed to design the shear reinforcement, then we'll use this particular formulas. Okay, if VCD exceeds, okay, then accordingly we will calculate the area of shear reinforcement, stirrups and spacing. Okay, like that. Okay, it is the simple numerical for sections cracked in flexure for a web section, that is T section. Okay. If you have any doubts regarding the calculation of all the part that we have done in this lecture, then you can message me or you can contact me directly. Okay. Just mark your attendance in comment box by commenting your name and roll number. Okay. Thank you. Stay safe.